Life Mandala. Kushan Peace Promotion is an enterprise providing a new space for active interaction between India, Central Asia, and China, as well as Pakistan, Afghanistan, and West Asia, and is planned to be the instrument of the Great Silk Road for this century, following the golden epoch of Kushan era. Kushan Peace Promotion will cover all the modes for active interaction between people through trade, culture, spirituality, tourism, and education. Pundarika strive to restore the glory of original and unique Indian spirituality, which has existed since the Buddha's time, and to being a new era of global awakening to our world. Pundarika is a new spiritual movement of the youth of India who have dedicated themselves to the success of the spirit of Mahatma Gandhi and his original vision. Since time immemorial throughout all history, humanity have been striving for the realization of its highest ideal, drove by its deepest spiritual aspiration. No doubts, the Buddha, fully awakened one, embodies perfection of such image. The new era of human awakening began after him. However, we can trace back profound formation process of such human spirituality evolution since the prehistorical era, widely throughout Eurasian continent and Indian subcontinent. Our story begins by restoring the lost link of the birth of Bodhisattva ideal and ancient spirituality of prehistorical nomads culture. They were known as Skif, Skithai, Sakha, and Chakya. Their habitats and movement covered the vast space of Central Eurasian steppes, stretching from the Black Sea, Ukraine, Russia, and Kazakh steppes, Caucasus, the Pamir Plateau, Tian Shan, Southern Siberian Altai, Mongol steppe, and northern China up to Korean Peninsula. All those nomad spirituality share distinctive, unique commonality, cosmic mysticism, spiritual heroism of selfless and fearless love and wisdom, honoring such heroes in eternal oneness with heaven and earth. Such spirituality later shaped the core characters of Bodhisattva ideal. Here are ancient sakas fashioned with songs presented from Altai and Tian Shan. Buddha was popularly called Shakyamuni, saint of Sakya, as descendant and inheritor of once the greatest spiritual federation. Of all ancient nomads bounded by honorable brotherhood and heroism all over Eurasia continent, the Sangha, which the Buddha initiated to form, were founded on such principles of ancient Sakya federations. Now we come to the Sadharma Pandarika, final conclusion of Buddha Sakyamuni's all teachings, ultimate revelations of eternal truth, of all Buddha's supreme wisdom, sacred eternal oneness of whole universe and life in infinite cosmic divine power and our own beings. The great cosmic assembly of Sadharma Pandarika is unfolding deepest secret mystery of cosmic miracles. Each of such miracles is nothing but parts of eternal cosmic mandala of whole oneness of the Buddha universe. Every epoch of this cosmic drama is played with great figures of Bodhisattvas. Each Bodhisattva has his own role, mission, power and character from his past into present and future. Dialogue between two great Bodhisattvas, Manjushri and Maitreya, initiate the opening of this great cosmic drama. The Buddha, in his profound meditation, radiates innumerable rays of light between his eyebrow. Lights illuminates entire universe of all existence, indicating the wholesome enlightenment of all universe. Manjushri has been always a key witness to this cosmic enlightenment of all past Buddhas. He is the upholder of the sacred treasure of this cosmic wisdom of the previous Buddhas. After every past Buddha, he motivated and instructed all new Bodhisattvas to attain this supreme wisdom. Thus, Manjushri became a teacher of all past Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. Now, Manjushri foretell Maitreya of the Buddha Sakyamuni's ultimate revelation of Sadharma Pundarika, utmost secret reality of universal Buddhahood of all existence.
now comes the second Bodhisattva, Medicine King. On behalf of 80,000 Bodhisattvas assembly, Medicine King received from the Buddha first ever assurance. Sadharma Pundarika, ensure everyone once and for all that once you hear even one sentence of this revelation, you surely attain the supreme enlightenment. In the later age, followed after the Buddha's Nirvana, if you could adhere and uphold core essence of Sadharma Pundarika, you are the avatar of the great Bodhisattva who specially chose to be born in this age to save the world. The story of the Medicine King's previous Bodhisattva life will illustrate the most characteristic quality of ancient nomads, spirituality of heroism. By hearing the Sadharma Pundarika from the Buddha, he obtained the unmovable mind power, Samadhi, which enables him to manifest his body in all forms of existence of all cosmos. His loyalty and adherence to Sadharma Pundarika and his master, the Buddha, lead him to offer his body and life by burning his body, which fire illuminate entire universe of all Buddha lands. This noble act shaken all heavenly world and liberate him from death. He returned alive to his father king and his master, the Buddha. His touching reunion with the Buddha was in time before the Buddha's Nirvana. In turn, the master honored the disciple's self-sacrifice and loyalty by instructing him thus. My time of Nirvana has come. This midnight, I will enter Parinirvana. My good son, I entrust you all that belong to me, all Buddha Dharma, great group of my Bodhisattva disciples, my Anuttara Samyak Bodhi Dharma, all my treasure lands, protected by all heavenly beings, as well as my remains of the Sharira. You should honor them by widely spreading and erecting thousands of stupas. His sorrowful longing for the Buddha made him to build 84,000 stupas and honoring them with his own arms burned by fire. Total devotion and loyalty to the one to whom he indebted all his spiritual liberation did supersede his death even by his heroic self-renunciation. Unbroken diamond lineage only can be transmitted by such immortal unity of guru and disciple. Later, Bodhisattva Medicine King solemnly declared before the Buddha that he will protect by his divine supernatural power the diamond lineage of Sadharma Pundarika to remain in this Saha world in later age after the Buddha Shakyamuni's Parinirvana, against all odds of Mara's force.
Here, next, are the unique performances of two Bodhisattvas, Avalokiteshvara and Wonderful Sound. Both Bodhisattvas can freely interact with all different Buddha lands and different realms of 10 worlds. Wonderful Sound could appear in one place. At the same time, he could appear simultaneously at many different places, in all universe, with any appearances of different beings, such as Brahma King, Indra, Maheshwara, Heavenly Commander, Chakravartin, World King, Minister, Millionaire, Brahmin, Bhikshu, Bhikshuni, Upasaka, Upasika, any women, little boy and girl, and all kinds of heavenly beings and dragons. Such are his capacity as savior of his divine supernatural power of manifestation and wisdom for the Saha world, as well as in innumerable worlds of all 10 directions of universe. In short, thanks to his manifestation, every forms of beings can show the Sadharma Pundarika's ultimate reality. His great Bodhisattva action originate in his Samadhi, manifesting in all form of bodies. Similarly, Bodhisattva Avalokiteshvara, wandering at many different lands, freely manifests all kind of forms of appearances and emancipates all living beings. He responds to anyone who are in any danger and horrific situation by providing fearlessness and rescue. Both Bodhisattvas are best examples how the power of ultimate wisdom of Sadharma Pundarikas enables Bodhisattvas obtain such cosmic body that manifests in all form of existence, delivering and enlightening all living beings. Another great Bodhisattva who is deeply connected with Sadharma Pundarika is Bodhisattva Samantabhadra. He always acted as final instructor and bestowal of all Bodhisattvas who are about to depart from original ignorance and to enter the ultimate stage of wonderful enlightenment. Samantabhadra will be a protector and guide for all keepers and practitioners of Sadharma Pundarika in later age. By his guidance, today we can learn to repent and purify our all previous karma and obtain our freedom from karmic delusion and enter into cosmic body of the Dharmakaya world. His instruction, approval and blessings is key for all Bodhisattvas' final enlightenment. Thank you.
Sadharma Pundrika is all-embracing, eternal cosmic mandala of all unified universe of one eternal Buddha Shakyamuni. Central figure of this cosmic miracle is the seven treasure stupa, which the Buddha Shakyamuni opened and entered into after triple miraculous transformation of this Saha world into one unified pure land where all cosmic Buddhas of all universe assembled together in order to witness the greatest cosmic prophecy. The Buddha Shakyamuni, seated inside the stupa, proclaims over all cosmic assembly, "Who can maintain and inherit the diamond lineage of Sadharma Pundarika for all future in this Saha world after my Nirvana?" Among all matters and missions, this is the most difficult task, which require each one's profound and great vow. This is my earnest wish, as much as all Buddhas. Since by keeping Sadharma Pundarika, you keep my body and of the Buddha of all times. All Buddhas approve such keeper with delight and joy. His voice penetrates all cosmic assembly. However, the Buddha did not appoint anyone for this most serious mission among the assembly. All of a sudden, the great earth broke, and from below, waves and waves of great numbers of Bodhisattvas emerged, whom no one in the Pundarika assembly ever saw before. Bodhisattva Maitreya, central for this new revelation, represents all assemblies, astounds and doubts, and put forwards central question to the Buddha. Who are those great Bodhisattvas? Maitreya and all assembly, knowing nothing about them, replying to the Maitreya's question, the Buddha revealed the core of the profoundest truth of what Sadharma Pundarika is all about. Those Bodhisattvas are true eternal sons of the Buddha Shakyamuni, entitled to inherit this eternal diamond lineage of Sadharma Pundarika and bring forth his wonderful power in later age to come. There are four great Bodhisattvas, prime initiators amongst all great number of the Bodhisattva, emerging below the earth. Uppermost action, boundless action, purifying action, and peacemaking action. The Buddha urged Maitreya three times to be prepared to embrace the truest enlightened Tathagata's own wisdom. true realm of the Buddha Shakyamuni and his Sadharma Pundarika, cosmic enlightenment, is timeless eternity. The Saha world is his very eternal pure land. The Buddha is eternal. The most secret, mysterious, universally prevailing, divine power of the Tathagat manifests itself eternally in timeless, all universe and all existences. The whole cosmic assembly now witness the Buddha Shakyamuni bestowing the wholeness of Sadharma Pundarika to four great Bodhisattvas with entire assembly of all cosmic Buddhas manifesting immeasurable, boundless, incomprehensible, divine supernatural power that unified whole universe as one eternal pure land. The climax of entire cosmic miracle of Sadharma Pundarika is the solemn prophecy for the four great Bodhisattvas emerged below the earth, whose entrusted mission from the Buddha is to restore and bring back his profoundest spiritual awakening to the later future world and to unify whole mankind and realize eternal pure land on this earth.
At present, in this year, we are celebrating the 2600th anniversary of the Buddha Shakyamuni's supreme enlightenment. As a matter of fact, our contemporary world is in the era of later age of the decay of the Dharma. Last fifth of 500s after the Buddha's Nirvana. Sadharma Pundarika predict precisely that in this era, its cosmic prophecy should be fully realized throughout the world. Central for such realization is the second homecoming of Sadharma Pundarika to its original land. This is the task commissioned by eternal Buddha himself to those true eternal sons so as to reawaken the deepest Buddha nature of all humanity at the most crucial historical moment. After the Buddha, Buddha Dharma lineage spread from the west to eastwards from India for the last 2500 years. As the Dharma spread eastwards, the lineage of the Sadharma Pundarika also evolved. The first evidence were the first 10 stupa built in India to honor the sacred remains of the Buddha Shakyamuni. He is the only one amongst all world religions founders as we know today who inherited most sacred cosmology of ancient nomads' spirituality to honor the deathless hero in the sacred burial mounds, which symbolize eternal unity of heaven and earth. The great King Ashoka expanded this sacred lineage by widely building stupas upon all lands where once ancient Shaka union of spiritual heroism and brotherhood formed vast common spiritual space that unite Northern India, Central Asia, West Asia, and the present West. Later, we witnessed the same territorial space flourish at Kushan Confederation, in which real Bodhisattva civilization unified all nations and peoples from Europe, Central Eurasia, India, and China by Great Silk Route. Impact of Sadharma Pundarika is evident in all archaeological remains all over Kushan territory, which include present India, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Central Asia, and Eastern Turkestan of present China. Kumar Jiva was instrumental as translating the Sadharma Pundarika into Chinese and bringing new insight and thought through his life work to Chinese Buddhism. His spiritual roots represent Indo-Kushan Central Asian Buddhism that were merged during Kushan era as truly pan-Eurasian Gandhara civilization. However, throughout all trace of Sadharma Pundarika eastwards, the climax of its cosmic prophecy had never been taken as its core message, till Nichiren of Japan in 13th century proclaimed the new era to come by forthcoming great bodhisattvas who were entrusted this most dramatic mission. It was Nichiren who first foresaw the second homecoming of true cosmic power of Sadharma Pundarika to India with the sacred mantra of Namo Myo Ho Renge Kyo, and reawaken the deepest and eternal relation between the Buddha and his true eternal children of India.
The time of awakening has come, first in Asia in 20th century, when humanity came across two symbolic historic events that will determine the future of the whole world. One was the first use of nuclear weapons over two Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The other was the first ever nation building in modern human history of new free India led by Mahatma Gandhi's non-violent freedom struggle. At the dawn of crucial turning point in history, profound encounter of two great souls of Asia took place in India at Gandhi's ashram of Wardha. Gandhi received one Japanese Buddhist monk whose life mission was solely to realize the central prophecy of Sadharma Pundarika, which no one for last 2500 years Buddhist history ever tried to dedicate one's life for such mission. In 15 minutes of their meeting, Mahatma, great soul of India, who saw India's sole mission as saving all humanity from violent path, realized the deepest meaning of the prophetic message of Sadharma Pundarika from this humble monk, whom Gandhi later began calling Fuji Guruji. On that fateful meeting, Gandhi adopted the sacred mantra of Namo Myo Ho Renge Kyo and Dharma Dram for his daily ashram prayer as opening prayer, and continued to do so throughout his tireless life for the National Liberation Movement and the New Social Awakening Movement. He broke his last fasting in his life with this sacred mantra for the unity and peace of India during the post-partition mass violence. Mahatma Gandhi's lifelong search for truth and his total dedication for new united India brought him the deepest reunion with the eternal true spirit of the Buddha. The greatest prophecy with all cosmic miracle of Sadharma Pundarika became heroic history, making of new India and for the new era of global awakening. In today's India, you can see many new Vishwa Shanti stupas at major sacred cities of the Buddha as testimony to the return of the great spirit and cosmic unity of the Buddha during new nation building after independence of new India. Of Eurasian continent at Lumbini, birthplace of the Buddha Shakyamuni, on the Vesak full moon day, which marked the 2600th anniversary of his enlightenment. This memorial celebration coincided with full circle of the completion of 6 years ascetic meditation practice by Dharma Sangha, who entered and practiced in the deep natural forests of Bara near his native place since at his age of 16. We endorse and fully rejoice in his exemplary dedication of his life for the cause of the emancipation of all sentient beings from the sufferings and the attainment of world peace. All humanity is called today for the single issue of how to deliver our living planet Earth from imminent catastrophic consequences which threaten the very existence and continuity of the human species, its civilization and entire ecosystem of the planet. We are all aware that such a planetary scale catastrophe is nothing but a consequence of our own collective behavior and thinking. Time has long ago run out from us to continue indulging blindly in the achievements of collective modern civilization. In truth, there is no time left, but we should act now as one for the fundamental transformation of a mindset and instantaneous global awakening. Is it possible? We are here at Lumbini to reaffirm this as the only alternative for today's generations. The fully awakened one, Prince of Shakya Kingdom, was born here at Lumbini. His birth and his ultimate enlightenment demonstrate our equal possibility of today's universal awakening. Because his birth and his enlightenment are inherent in the very nature of all beings in the universe. The ultimate reality of whole universe, which the fully awakened one realized, originates in everyone's own nature. His awakening is the awakening of all, our awakening was His purpose of enlightenment. Each and every one of us embodies the eternal wholeness of the entire universe. Here is the reason for hope. If our generation can realize this essential unity and act as one, liberating the whole world from the deceptive division, nothing can divide and separate us. If we fail, there will be no future. Our awakening is the only future. We, the Pundarika Bodhisattva Gana, affirm this simple truth on the memorial full moon day and commence our new journey for the new era of instantaneous universal awakening. The world never experienced such a moment. This is the mission of our generation. Dharma Sangha's completion of his 6 years meditation in the Bara forest became the symbolic inauguration of our common spiritual journey for the new era. We share one compassion, one aspiration, and one mission. Here is the opportunity only once possible in human history, given as our mission, the mission that can fulfill the original purpose of the fully awakened one, that each and every one embraces, reverses, realizes and celebrates our eternal wholeness in the fully awakened world. From Lumbini today, we are calling for the dawn of the new era of world peace.
This is a first public performance of Bodhisattva Gana Mandala, and I would like to take this opportunity that in this performance there are Buddhists, Hindu, Muslims and Indians from China, from Russia, from Kyrgyzstan, from Kazakhstan, Nepal, Japan, and Chechnya. And I would like to mention, this performance was possible by the kind sponsorship of the Chinese Buddhist devotee who are not able to attend this conference. But this event itself demonstrates the future unity of all of us. Thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you.